So when we first open the help page of the control chart template and we scroll down to the instructions section, the very first instruction is to open a blank template sheet. And in order to do that, you're going to need to know which type of control chart you're going to want to use. So you click this link, which takes you to the online help training page that teaches you about the different types of control charts. So that when you scroll up and click the button to open a blank template sheet, you will know which type of chart is appropriate for your data. And you'll always know what type of chart you chose when you scroll over. It'll tell you right there in the type field. Our next step is to enter our header data. And notice that whatever title we enter here also appears in the chart. And whatever revised date we enter here also appears at the bottom of the chart. And we can enter the author name. And whatever we enter here will appear as our x-axis label. So our next step is to start entering data in these columns to the left. And if we click the pop-up help in the header, it tells us that if we want to have this column formatted in dates rather than in just numbers, period numbers, then we should change the cell format in both this column and the rolling time periods column. So let's enter a date in this cell. And we noticed that Excel was smart enough to automatically change the format of that cell to date format, but it didn't change the format for the corresponding cell in rolling time periods column. So let's select all of the cells in the time period column, right click Format Cells, and select the date format. And then select all the cells in the rolling time periods column and do the exact same thing. Those two columns need to be formatted the exact same way. So let's enter our dates. And of course, this is Excel, so you can grab that lower right corner and just drag it to use autofill, or drag it even more to continue the series. And you can use everything you know about Excel to either import your data or enter it, or we're just going to quickly copy some data and paste it and make a couple few quick changes. And then we notice that this red field up here says that our chart is not updated. So we click the button to update chart. And now our chart is updated. Now that update chart button is actually doing a lot of fancy things. Let's say for instance that we change the number of rolling periods, maybe to 10. When we select the button to update chart, notice that there are only 10 rows of data now in the rolling time periods column, and notice that the chart has been automatically scaled to only show 10 data points. But we are free to continue adding unlimited additional data in these white columns. And notice that the rolling time periods column will only display the 10 most recent data points. Now we notice that our chart is not updated because we added data, so we click the button to update chart, and now everything's right again. Now if you had chosen a C chart, then this column D for sample size wouldn't even be here because a C chart ignores sample size. But that's one of the advantages of a P chart or U chart, is it can take into consideration different sample sizes. And then the control lines can become wavy lines to show how sample size affects control limits. But if sample size only varies by a little bit, then you might want your control lines to still be flat rather than wavy. That's the purpose of the flatline threshold field. You define the ratio where you want your lines to be either flat or wavy. Now let's take a real-world situation where your process has been going along at a steady 100 for a long time, then all of a sudden, on row 26, you get starting having much bigger sample sizes. So obviously something in the real world changed about that process at that time. So rather than going along with a flat average line, you might want to enter the row number where the process changed. And notice that you enter the actual Excel row number, and then in the cell right beneath it, it will automatically calculate the corresponding row number in the rolling time period. Click Update Chart, and notice that your average and all of your control lines start with fresh calculations as of your process change. Now, the other thing that happens when you click the Update Chart button is it performs stability analysis, which is kind of the whole point of doing this in the first place. And when you follow this link to our suggested readings, where you can buy books on the subject, and there's also links to free online training that explain what were these authors thinking when they suggested these default values for stability analysis. Now, every expert agrees that if there's ever even a single point above the upper control limit or below the lower one, that should be highlighted and brought to your attention for investigation. But there are minor differences of opinion on the other ones. So if you, for instance, say, gosh, that sure looks like a trend to me, you can optionally enter your own N values. So for instance, you might say, I want to see trends of just 5 points in a row, not just 6. Then when you select the Update Chart button, it will highlight the chart based upon your specified N values. And the final really cool feature that we'll show you is the Copy Chart button. You just grab the lower corner of the chart to resize it to the size you want, and then you click the Copy Chart button, which copies a picture of your chart to the clipboard, where you can then paste it to any type of document, like maybe this PowerPoint document, making you look like the professional that you are.